Good morning, Windsor High. Today is April 27th, 2020. I'm Landon Reese.
And I'm TJ Collins. And this is your Windsor High School Video Bulletin.
Here's leadership with some important messages.
Hi everybody, last week's Media Monday was a huge success, so thank you to everybody who submitted your favorite song. This week, to kick off our throwback week, the theme is your favorite throwback movie. So if you want to be featured on WHS updates on Instagram, go on over to the Instagram story and submit your favorite throwback movie by today at 3.
Hey everyone, it's Mackenzie, your ASB Vice President. Thanks to everyone who participated in last week's TikTok Tuesday, which was quarantine routine. We love seeing how you guys have been spending your mornings recently. And if you didn't get a chance to check out that compilation video, it's still up on WHS Updates, so go check it out. This week's TikTok Tuesday theme is throwback. So send us a video of you recreating baby pictures, maybe showing us what you looked like freshman year, or maybe even just throwback to when we went to school. So make sure to DM us or email us those submissions by 3 o'clock tomorrow.
Hi everyone, last week's senior spotlight went extremely well and we got to highlight all of the senior athletes that have worked extremely hard this year. This week's theme is going to be all about throwback. So we're gonna be throwing it back to your freshman year of high school. So please send us pictures of you in your freshman year of high school or videos, whatever you have, and we'd love to highlight them on our story.
Hey Windsor, it's Gracie Hernandez here, one of your ASB Rally Commissioners, and I'm coming at you with a new theme for Teacher Takeover Thursday. This week's theme is throwback to high school. So teachers and staff, please send us one or a collage of photos of you from high school and tell us what decade they're from. Also tell us what your favorite song was from the times. I can't wait to see what you guys come up with.
Hey guys, it's Lacey Cash once again coming to tell you about the spirit for this week. If you want to be featured in this week's video of What's Up Windsor, send in a picture or video from one of your favorite moments from school, whether that was at a dance, at a rally, in class, or at lunch with your friends, anything. You guys may have noticed a reoccurring theme with the word throwback, and that's because this week is all about throwbacks. Also remember that all submissions will be taken no later than 3 p.m. the day the videos are released. We can't wait to see all of your guys' fun throwback videos, so make sure to send them in and tune in to What's Up Windsor next Friday at 4.
And here's a greeting from the WHS counseling staff.
Hey guys, this is Counselor Sabelle, and I just want to say that we miss you guys, and as we eagerly wait to get back to Windsor High School, I encourage you to reach out to us. We're here to help, and we can't wait to hear from you.
Kia Windsor High School students, this is Senior Jauregui, Counselor. Sigan echándole ganas y adelante. Do what you can right now to take care of yourself and grow, so we can all emerge stronger. Stay well y hasta pronto.
Hi Jaguars, this is Eva. And I'm sending you a virtual hug. I do want to invite you, when you have a quiet moment, to think about how resilient you're actually being. Even when it's hard, you are growing in ways you can't even imagine at this time. I wish you all well and look forward to seeing you guys soon.
Hi Windsor High Jags, it's Lauren from counseling. We miss you guys and hope that you're doing well. We will get through this. I want you to know the comeback is always stronger than the setback. Take care and stay safe.
Hi everyone at Windsor High. I miss seeing all of you up in the counseling department. I am spending this afternoon screening with my grandson. Yes, I'm not social distancing from him, but we see each other all the time. It is his first birthday. This is Lakai. Everybody stay safe. Miss you.
Hi everyone, this is Mindy, one of the counselors. I just wanted to reach out to you and tell you that we miss you, we love you, and we hope you're all doing okay. And remember,
the Santa Rosa Junior College summer schedule of classes is now online. Go to classes.santarosa.edu for more information. Students can begin submitting their dual enrollment forms for summer courses to their counselors as soon as possible, but preferably before May 15th.
The next SRJC virtual office hours is Thursday, April 30th from 1 to 3:30 p.m. This is for grades 9 to 12. Visit the WHS College and Career website for Zoom meeting information at whscollegecenter.weebly.com.
There will be an online SRJC presentation for seniors on May 1st from 2 p.m. to 3 p.m. The SRJC counselor will provide information on priority registration, financial aid, and transfer to four-year institutions. More information on logging into the Zoom meeting is available on the whscollegecenter.weebly.com website.
Some of the biggest challenges that we've had with our dance classes with this distance learning is having the space available and the time. So not everybody has the same availability within their schedule right now for a lot of different reasons. And secondly, space is all of us have different houses or apartments or whatever. So we can still move, but more compact and in a way I would say restricting, not impossible, but how we approach the movement is completely different.
For me, it's really challenging. For me personally, my mom's house, I have a little bit more space in my room. I have a bigger mirror in there, but at my dad's house, it's super small. So if I want to dance, I would go in the living room, but sometimes he's out there, my other family members. So it can definitely be really challenging.
One of the things our students are going to be doing will be assessing what resources they have available to them. Some students have things like basketballs or free weights at their homes, so they have that as a resource. Other students are going to start using YouTube as a resource for ideas.
I really think that we learn best as humans in a social way. And so my challenge, what I've tried to do, is really figure out how can we create an online community that's as connected as what we have in the classroom? And that's what I'm trying to do.
Every Thursday, I also teach a class on Zoom, and it's so awkward. It just feels so weird. Is not only are you just talking to yourself, because I have to have them all on mute so they can see me, but you don't get that energy from each other. Like feeling the music as well in you, it's so hard to explain.
I think like all students right now are missing community. They're missing their people. And whether that's a sports team or whether it's a class, to be separated from people and your peers is a tough thing.
I think it's definitely harder when we don't have like our friends always there to talk to or like ask questions or whatever.
It's just hard not to see their faces almost every day.
Right now, I put it in their hands mostly. For my three A dancers, I send them a video where it's myself dancing with the music all the way through, and then a video where I'm breaking it down and telling them the steps. But again, all the movement is really compact. For my more advanced dancers, I've given them three different project options. They have the option to either create their own solo. Their second option is they can create and teach dance combinations. Third one, which is the most popular one so far, is having the kids participate in a bunch of different social media dance challenges.
I've been working on the project that Ms. Schneider assigned, but I definitely think it's difficult to participate in an activity like dance during quarantine, just because like the thing that I loved about dance, obviously at school, was that like we would be together in a group.
One thing that's really kind of uplifting is, hear me out, everybody, hearing how bored and stir crazy some people are, like, oh, I want to move, or I've been having to do this, or I've started going on walks with my dog, and we didn't even prompt that, you know. Hearing that is good because it gives us the feedback of, well, at least they want to be moving. And that's step one, is building that intrinsic motivation.
I was already doing like exercises at home. So I already like had that motivation to work out and exercise at my house. I'm improving because it's workouts and getting exercise in is always good.
I mean, personally, I think being isolated has kind of helped me like find myself again in a way, so that once I'm doing choreography, it's more of my personality. Like, I'm not just trying to do choreo to like impress others, but I'm doing choreo because I had the time to like figure out who I am and put my personality into the piece.
Here's a preview of our 2020 Windsor High School yearbook with important ordering information. And here's some news about our varsity girls basketball team.
Ladies, how are we doing? And I wanted to congratulate all of you for receiving the 2019-2020 North Coast Section Scholastic Pennant. Three schools out of 177 get this pennant, and you ladies did a fantastic job in the classroom this year. So that pennant is going to be placed in the gymnasium here soon, and I just want to give you all a shout out. So I thought I would give you a video instead of just a text, all right? Love y'all. Hope you're all staying safe. I'll talk to you soon.
And here are Windsor High School's 2020 Athletes of the Year.
Hi, Windsor High School. This is Jamie Williams, your athletic director. And I come to you with some amazing news that we have our Athletes of the Year and our Scholar Athletes of the Year award winners. I am super proud of all four of you. Well-deserved awards. Your coaches, some of them were able to give some kind words as well as some teachers. So without further ado, here they are. Our Female Athlete of the Year award winner is Riley West. Congratulations, Riley. Volleyball, basketball, track, and swimming. All your coaches had amazing things to say about you.
Riley, congratulations. I just heard that you are the Windsor High School Female Athlete of the Year. I'm excited for you. It's well deserved. Volleyball, basketball, and swimming. Congratulations, all right? Good luck in the future. Go Jags!
You've been a great representative of our track and field team for the last 2 years, and it's been your hard work and leadership that's turned our program into what it is today.
You are one of the strongest and most competitive young ladies I've seen out there, and I've had the privilege to coach.
Thanks for being such an inspiration for all the kids on the team. You're going to go do great things, and I'm really going to miss you.
You are the true definition of a team player, and it was an honor coaching you. Congrats, Riley.
Our Male Athlete of the Year award winner goes to Connor Wong. Connor Wong is an amazing champion swimmer. Connor, congratulations on breaking some school records and making it to state multiple years. We look forward to seeing some of the great things you'll do in the future.
Hey, Connor. It's Coach Kelly, AKA Mom. Just can't tell you how proud I am of you of getting Windsor High School Male Athlete of the Year. You sure deserve it. You worked so hard for your grades and being on the swim team, AP classes, and Eagle Scout. When you're in the water, you're a beast. When you're home with your family, you're a kind, sweet person. Thank you for all you do. We're so proud of you.
Congratulations, Connor. Now just make sure you're studying for your AP tests.
Congratulations, Connor Wong.
Well deserved. You're a scholar and a gentleman, a true historical competitor, and in the pool and in the classroom.
Michael Phelps is shuddering.
You're on your way, and well deserved again, and wish we could be with you to celebrate.
All right, take care.
And finally, our Scholar Athlete of the Year award winners go to Gracie Hernandez, who's done awesome job on our varsity softball team and in the community. Thank you for being a humble spirit out there and a beast on the field.
Congratulations, Gracie, on being selected Windsor High School's Female Athlete of the Year. Your accomplishments, though, go far beyond the athletic field or your scholastic achievements. I'm so proud to have witnessed your growth as a leader on our campus and amongst your peers and within the Windsor community through our leadership program and specifically this year as an ASB officer. Good luck with all that you choose to do in the future. I'm so proud of you and so thrilled that you've gotten this award. Congratulations.
And our Scholar Athlete of the Year award winner for the boys goes to Billy Boyle. Congratulations, Billy. As a football quarterback and a basketball three-point shooting star, you had an opportunity to lead with kindness, integrity, and all those attributes that we were looking for. But most importantly, being able to juggle the schoolwork as well.
Hey, Jags, it's Coach G here. I want to congratulate Billy Boyle on being awarded this year's Windsor High School Boys Scholar Athlete of the Year.
You definitely work hard for it and deserve it. I know your family's proud of you. I'm proud of you, and all the other coaches are proud of you. Keep working hard, and I wish you the best in the future, buddy.
Well deserved. You're a scholar and a gentleman and a stellar athlete.
Well done.
A true competitor in the classroom and on the court and the field.
You represent AP well.
Good job. Congratulations.
Seniors, mark your calendar for the afternoon of April 30th. This is the planned day to distribute Johnson's announcement, caps, and gowns. We will have more information sent out to the seniors later today by email.
Here's admin with an important message.
Hey Jags, it's Mrs. Ziegler, and I have a message for you to stay in touch with your teachers. I know we're away at distance learning. Today I'm sheltering at home, and the orange blossoms here smell amazing. But you need to keep in touch with your teachers. They're taking attendance every week. We just want to make sure you're staying engaged, and we look forward to seeing you in real time sometime again soon.
Hey Jags, we haven't forgotten about you. I hope you haven't forgotten about us. Remember to check in with your teachers every week, regardless of whether or not you're completing work. Go Jags!
Hello, seniors. We miss you, and we have some big plans to celebrate you. We've not forgotten you. We know how hard you work, and we've got some pretty cool things in store for you. Go Jags!
That's all for now. Stay safe.
Keep up with your classes and stay positive.
Remember to follow WHS updates on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter.
And we'll see you next week. Good morning, Windsor.
Good morning, Windsor.
And we'll see you next week.